Greetings, Benjamin J. the Victrola Guy here. Just wanted to do a quick video on this little Victor talking machine. This is a VVIV from 1912. Haven't cleaned it up. I got it a couple weeks ago. I'm just now getting around to playing with it. And it's an oak case. It has a dealer tag on the side from Rhode Island. And it's 1912 Victor. It's in really decent shape. Obviously, it needs a good cleaning. It's got some stains on it, but I can get this oak cleaned up. I have recovered the turntable just to make it look nicer. It was just bare metal when I got here. Haven't done anything to the bright work yet. And as you can see, I'm scraping things off of it. So I have installed a non-Victor reproducer. This is one of the best reproducers I've ever used. It's actually an English reproducer, and I adapted it to fit Victor machines, and it sounds quite good. So let's put a record on. This is Waiting for the Robert E. Lee by Al Jolson, of course. And as you can see, it's missing one of the legs. So just getting around to doing anything with it. Once I get it cleaned up, it's going to be a nice little machine. It's loud, it's bright, it's crisp. That reproducer made it to come alive. Now, you know the early machines, there's no horn in them. Basically, you lift the lid off, there's two angled boards, and the motor sits directly in the middle of the horn. So they sound kind of dead if you put an exhibition reproducer, even a number two on it. They just don't have any life. They're not bright, they're not crisp. Put an aluminum reproducer or aluminum diaphragm reproducer on it, something off of a portable machine, or in this case, this has a nice big diaphragm in it. And what I did to adapt it was I epoxied a Victor bushing into it to eliminate the rubber bushing in the screw. So I just epoxied the bayonet mount off a Victor reproducer into it. And it says Savannah Premier British. No idea what I've seen other ones that look identical to it with six different names on them. But these are really nice reproducers. They're loud and they have a really bright sound to them. They're really excellent reproducers. And now that I've adapted it to fit the Victor, I can put it on any Victor machine. Looks good, sounds good, which is what it's all about. So, without further ado, let's start the machine. Didn't even have to rebuild the motor. Just going to do a quick cleanup on it, and but in the meantime, I just wanted to show it to you. This is a nice, old 1912 Victor machine.
On a moonlight night, you can find them all. While they're waiting, the band knows a thing to pay them. What's that they're saying? What's that they're saying? While they keep playing, a humming and swaying, it's a good ship. Robert E. Lee, that's from McCarry, they're cutting away. Watch them chopping along. See them chopping along. Go take yourself, gal. Your real pal. Go down to the levee. I said, Levy, darn that shuffling throng. Hear that music and song. It's in big place, mate. Waiting on the levy, waiting for the drama to be.
This is a nice little Victor machine, almost 100 years old, 1912. So 99 years old and still going strong. All it needs is a good cleaning, be cleaning up the cabinet, polishing the bright work. This one I'm keeping. So it's going to be a resident here, I think. And there have been nicer ones, but this is an old machine that's in good, honest condition, and really like this one. So in any case, just wanted to show it to you. Neat old Victor machines. Picked this up for $80. So that was cool. If you have any questions about the Victor machine, any machine that I've posted on my channel, any of the Edison recordings, any questions, comments, feel free to drop me a line, the Victrola guy at gmail.com. And as always, thank you for watching.